God allowed Satan to test his servant Job, a perfect and an upright man. Satan gives Job painful boils and takes his cattle and children. Jan Lievens here shows Job sitting on a dunghill. Job's pose and worn body show his suffering. Behind him, his wife scorns him for stubbornly retaining his integrity. God has abandoned the virtuous Job to the devil. Having lost everything, he sits in abject misery while demons torment him. Holding a plumed hat and gold chain, symbols of his former wealth, Job's wife challenges him, "Do you still persist in your integrity? Curse God, and die." Lievens painted this in competition with Rembrandt, his friend and rival. Both artists sought to find compelling and novel means of exploring emotional states. Job's mute but powerfully expressive body conveys his resignation to divine will. Frame, carved wood, gilded. Britain, second half 17th, early 18th century after a French model.
Let's dive in. So Job begins with a strange story that takes place up in the heavens, which are described something like a heavenly command center. So God is there with these angelic creatures called the sons of God, and they're all there reporting for duty.
And God points out this guy Job, his servant, showing how righteous and good he is.
And then one of these angelic creatures approaches. He's referred to in Hebrew as the Satan.
The Satan? Who's this?
Well, this word is actually a title, which literally means the one who is opposed. So out of this whole crew, he is the one questioning how God is running the world. And he proposes that Job might not actually love God, that he's only a good person because God rewards him. If God were to take away all of the good things he gave to Job, then we would see his true colors.
So he thinks Job is just working the system?
That's exactly right. Maybe he's obeying just to get what he wants.
So God agrees to this experiment and allows the Satan to inflict suffering on Job.
And Job loses everyone and everything that he cares about. It is devastating. And remember, he deserves none of this. God himself said so.
The remarkable thing is that in the midst of all this suffering, Job still praises God.
Jan Lievens is among the most fascinating and enigmatic Dutch artists of the 17th century. Daring and innovative as a painter, draftsman, and printmaker, he created character studies, genre scenes, landscapes, formal portraits, and religious and allegorical images that were widely praised and highly valued during his lifetime. Lievens, whose father, Lieven Hendricks, was a skilled embroiderer, began his career in Leiden in the early to mid-1620s. During the late 1620s, Lievens and his Leiden colleague Rembrandt van Rijn, Dutch, 1606-1669, had a close, symbiotic relationship that manifested both in the style and the subject matter of their works.